See those little black boxes? They're called telephones. I'm gonna let you in on a little secret about these telephones. They're not gonna dial themselves, okay? Without you, they're just a worthless hunk of plastic. Like a loaded M16 without a trained marine to pull the trigger. And in the case of the telephone, it's up to each and every one of you, my highly trained stratonites, my killers. My killers who will not take no for an answer. My freaking warriors who will not hang up the phone until the client either buys or freaking dies. In today's video, I would like to talk about cold phone calls. We all have to make them now and then, don't we? And as for me, I really hated them and deemed to be the most irritant, the most repugnant, the most time-wasting instrument in sales. How much time do we waste when finding the right person? We, Knights of Sales Kingdom, have to trample through the wild wood of different phone numbers and email addresses until we finally try to pass the dragon in the person of secretary or assistant, and in the very end save the right person from the claws of competition. How much time, effort, and nerve cells do we burn while doing this? Well, I partially agree with that. Cold phone call is a very effective sales tool, but if it is the only sales tool the company uses, sorry, but I would rather question the sanity of the sales strategy creator. So how to turn occasional, I stress occasional, cold phone calls into efficient and interesting sales tool? Before taking a phone, a whole bunch of fears comes out into our head. What if they reject me? What if I fail to deliver my idea? What if they tell me to f***? Well, that is natural. I admit that before making a phone call, I tend to remember that I have to do this, to do that. Oh, and that also. And finally, I find a reason not to make this phone call at all. But guys, after all, the prospect can't hurt you. It is natural that he rejects your product or your idea. There is nothing wrong with that. After all, more than 90% of cold phone calls end up in waste bin. So what? A good way to oppose the fear of rejection is taking more risks. The bolder you are, the more potent is the weapon against shilly-shally. Think of shyness as your worst enemy. It is ruining you and making you unhappy. So combat it with commitment to your own happiness and your own success. After all, what are you losing? A simple phone call? This is ridiculous. No matter what you are selling, a pen or a million-dollar production line, you cannot afford the risk of being caught flat-footed. Before making a call, it is essential to do research both on customer and on the product he might be interested in. There is no need to chant the praises to your company and product if you don't concentrate on customer's needs, because otherwise he feels he was one of the 100 persons you have called today, one of the 100 persons who rejected your offer. So concentrate on what is important for him. Avoid general epithets, spare your wow for the purchase. Instead, give precise numbers, facts, and references. For example, you are calling a milk factory to offer milk filling equipment. Imagine you are one of, say, 10 suppliers who offer roughly the same product. So do not waste your time describing how successful your company is, how lucky he is today to receive such a tremendous offer. Instead, give numbers. X capacity, Z work efficiency, 0.000001% of product loss. Similar solution installed recently at his competitor's factory. Machine works impeccably fast and still is not broken. If he is interested, you might send some offer or fix a meeting. If not, okay, you did everything you could. But it is very likely that with this approach, the customer will at least bear in mind your offer and remember you for future projects. The first seconds of your first call define whether the call is bound to remain cold or will warm up. The way you present yourself and kick off will buy your next 30 seconds, a minute, 5 minutes, and so on. Actually, the whole conversation is pushing away time boundaries. You battle for every minute, and the way you act, and especially start to act, will render this phone call successful or total failure. There is a certain tempo of working day in the office, and not only in the office, but since we are targeting buyers, they are most likely not to be working in a foundry shop. Working day normally starts at 8 or 9 a.m. and it usually takes 1 hour for morning meeting or to get one's act together, pour some coffee, a small talk with colleague. So basically the most intense working part is from 10 to 12 a.m. At this time you're most likely to hit the bull's eye, especially if you call around 10 o'clock and your call is the first one. Then comes lunchtime and the sleepy hour. Have you ever noticed how quiet it is after lunch? No one is talking, no phone calls, it's all peace and quiet. And after 2 p.m. the best part recommences. Phone ringing, your neighbor screaming on the phone like crazy. So why not make a call? Normally, the best hours for calling in the afternoon are between 2 and 5 p.m. The worst thing is there have been so much information during the day that your call is most likely to be lost in the sea of other importunate ones. So better call in the morning before they start to wreak the havoc. In other words, 92% give up after 4 contacts, and only 8% of salespeople are closing 80% of overall sales. So tenacity pays off. Well, I do not advise to be a pesky fly and bother the customer till he blocks you everywhere, but sensible insistence will most certainly pay off. If you finally managed to get to the right person on the phone, correctly introduced yourself and the customer took the bait and started to talk, for heaven's sake, do not interrupt him. You are all ears. You are a sponge which is absorbing as much information as possible. Try to make the impression his problems are of primarily importance to your business. Do not get distracted or talk simultaneously, because that will be the end of conversation. Even the phone can convey our attitude by the way we talk and breathe. So get as much information as possible and only then you start to talk. Never put the cart before the horse. Okay, so you finally managed to get as much information as possible from the customer and you understand that your product is exactly what he needs. Guys, patience, please. No forcing. Do not go crazy about your product being the best possible solution in the world. Best quality price ratio. How could he possibly exist without it? Once again, keep calm and wait a wee bit. If you ever went fishing, you might know this. You suddenly feel something heavy as a whale. If you are a beginner, you get so excited that you start to pull as much as you can. And unfortunately, the whale jumps off. Experienced fishermen do not go nuts and pull the sea line, they just wait till the fish gets the bait completely. And only then they start to slowly push inch by inch. So try not to scare away the customer, and your patience will most certainly pay off. That is a piece of advice I would like to suggest at the end of conversation. Whether it has been successful or not, please try. Ask the customer, may I please ask you one last question? In 99% of cases, he will say yes. And depending on how the conversation went, you may ask either what you forgot to ask or what you wanted to ask him in the beginning, but for some reason you failed. And since this is the end of the conversation, the topic is bound to be the most memorable. So guys, this is basically it concerning code phone calls. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any other ideas how to turn a code phone call into a hot one, please share your thoughts in the comment section below. I also kindly ask you to put a like, nor a dislike, and please subscribe to my channel. I want you to back yourself into a corner. Give yourself no choice but to succeed. Let the consequences of failure become so dire and so unthinkable that you have no chance but to do whatever it takes to succeed. Thank you for watching this video.